Hello from ChemHelp ASAP. In this video, we're going to look at some special Lewis dot structures. And these are Lewis structures of the common acids, sulfuric acid, phosphoric acid, and nitric acid. And we're going to cover these specially because they're a little different than most Lewis structures that we will encounter in organic chemistry. So what are the rules for Lewis dot structures? The rules are, number one, you want to fill the octets of your atoms. Number two, you want to minimize your number of formal charges. And number three, when you do have formal charges, you want to place them as reasonably as possible. Normally that means negatives on electronegative atoms and positives on less electronegative atoms. So let's look at these structures. So the first is sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid has sulfur surrounded by a bunch of oxygens. Now, oxygen will always require two bonds. So, sulfur can take two bonds to both of those oxygens, but it's only going to have one bond to the other oxygen, and we're going to have hydrogens coming off of there. Sometimes people try to string this along as a bunch of oxygens. That's not what sulfuric acid looks like. Now, oxygen doesn't have a full octet yet. All these oxygens have two lone pairs. And that is sulfuric acid. Why are we talking about sulfuric acid? Well, it's a very common reagent in organic chemistry. And the reason it's kind of difficult is it violates the octet rule. So we have 12 electrons on sulfur. So it violates the octet rule. It's a third row element that's allowed. So that's why sulfuric acid is special. This is the Lewis structure of sulfuric acid. How about phosphoric acid? It's much like sulfuric acid. Phosphorus, in this case, is going to expand its octet. It has a double bond to an oxygen, and then three OHs coming off of it. So again, here's a molecule that has a central atom that is just surrounded by oxygens. Again, phosphorus as a third row element can expand its octet. So we have 10 electrons on phosphorus. Nitric acid. Nitric acid is weird because it's a molecule that when we draw the Lewis structure, it is going to require formal charges. Most organic molecules do not have formal charges. And so we get used to the idea that nothing ever has formal charges. Well, here's a stable molecule that's neutral that does have formal charges. So again, we have these oxygens surrounding one of our atoms. It's kind of a theme for these molecules. And nitrogen has to take four bonds. Nitrogen typically has three bonds. With four bonds, it's going to have a positive charge. And this oxygen ends up having an O minus. But you notice we do place our formal charges reasonably. The O minus, the minus is on the oxygen, our most electronegative atom in the molecule. And at least we put the positive on the nitrogen and not on oxygen. So this nitric acid is weird because it has must have formal charges. So these are three common molecules that sort of bend our typical Lewis dot structure rules that we encounter for organic molecules. Note that these are not actually organic molecules, but we'll use them a lot in organic chemistry.